Dioba. Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Tamada's Table. Today we will be making beef stew khracho. Khracho is a very popular dish in Georgia. Actually, there are a variety of khracho dishes. It can be soup, it can be stew. What is in common among all these dishes is that they are made with traditional Georgian spices, such as khmeli-suneli. And khmeli-suneli is widely available. It's on Amazon, so no problem of getting khmeli-suneli. In today's version, I'll show you how to combine two delicious sauces, tomato sauce and the walnut sauce, and we will cook in it with beef. But of course, khracho can use any kind of meat, chicken, lamb, beef, veal. So it's up to you, make your choice, and let's start cooking. Here is my beef, which I cut into 2-inch cubes. My tomatoes, fresh cilantro, chili pepper, garlic, walnuts, onions, and spices. I will start making tomato sauce, and I heated my skillet, so I will add some vegetable oil. And when it's hot, I will add onions. Here I have about 2 cups of onions, but I will be using only half of it for tomato sauce. I'm cooking my onions in the vegetable oil until they are tender and golden brown. For tomato sauce today, I will be using 2 different kinds of tomatoes. One is diced tomatoes, here they are. I'll put it in the bowl. And tomato sauce, because they say if you combine different types of tomatoes, the sauce comes more delicious. So that's what we'll be doing today. And then, you see, so I have cilantro here. It's fresh cilantro. And you know that I don't like waste in my cooking. So what I will do, I will prepare cilantro paste. But first I will stir my onions because the noise tells me that they are happily cooking, but it's time to stir them. Now I will cut the stems of cilantro and I will keep the leaves for later. But this I will just coarsely chop like that. And I'll put it in my food processor together with a pinch of coarse salt. And then just turn off your processor. So my cilantro pesto is ready. I'll just put it into a small bowl and I will continue making my tomato sauce. Cilantro has such nice aroma. Every time I cook with cilantro, you know, it reminds me of Georgia. It reminds me of my childhood, how my granny, how my mother were cooking. So it's very nice. So my onions are ready. You can see that they are tender and they are turning into golden brown. And that's exactly the way I want them. So I will be adding my combination of tomato sauce and tomato, diced tomatoes. Ho, ho, ho. Now mix and cook on low heat for about 10 minutes. Cooking, I have these beautiful leaves of cilantro, so let me cut them because we will be using them in the sauce. So I chopped finally my cilantro and now let's put it in the bowl and start working with other ingredients. So you can see the tomato sauce is simmering and now I will be adding my cilantro pesto and half of the cilantro leaves I chopped, only half. The rest we will need for garnishing and we will be adding at the end of the cooking. Now mix well and continue cooking for a few minutes. I didn't even use spices, but aroma from cilantro, tomatoes, onions, it's already like so mouth-watering. The tomato sauce is done. This is final mix. And I will remove it from the heat and I'll put it aside. Let's cook meat. I will be using my cast iron pot, but you can use any heavy, deep pot you like. I put my meat into the heated pot And now I will be cooking it for about 15-20 minutes covered on medium heat. So this is one of the techniques we use in Georgia while cooking our delicious stews. We want just to cook the meat in its own juices without adding any ingredients. As you can see, the meat started releasing its juices. And that's exactly what we want. So cover it and wait for 15-20 minutes, as I told you. Now let's make walnut sauce. So I'm putting walnuts into the food processor. I'm adding 3 garlic cloves and a pinch of coarse salt. And now I'll proceed to make the paste from these walnuts. First, I will crush them. Now I will be adding spices to the walnut sauce. Mostly this is khmeli-suneli spice. This is ground coriander, and I will be adding some chili pepper. And continue grinding. To help grinding the walnuts, I can add splash of water, but I will be adding a little bit more than splash. I will be adding about 1/4 of the cup from the beginning. So my walnut paste is ready. What I will do now, I will add more water because I want my walnut paste to be more of like sour cream consistency. Why? Because it will be easier to put it into the pot. Here we are, so our walnut paste is done, and I can keep it in the cup of the food processor until I will be adding it to the beef. On the meat after 15 minutes. Ho 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 ho. See, that's the broth I wanted. So now it's the time to add some other ingredients, and I will add onions. It's about 1 cup of onions here, leftovers from all my onions, and 2 bay leaves. And again, I will cover it and cook for about another 10 minutes. So let's check on the meat. Yes, it's cooking, it's in all own juices, and I added some boiling water, so it's cooking very well. And let's see if the meat is fork tender. The meat is almost done, and this is the time when we will be adding other ingredients. Of course, one of our main ingredients is tomato sauce, which goes into the pot. Mix well. Now let's add walnut sauce. And again, mix. And you will see how tomato sauce will change its color immediately. I will add some chili pepper. And again, mix. Oh, the aromas are amazing. This chili pepper gave such freshness, you know, to the aromas in my kitchen and in my stew. So you can look at the color of the sauce. Now I will reduce the heat to very low, and I will simmer that for another 20 minutes. Let's check on our stew. It's cooking actually very well. Look at the color of the sauce. And we didn't add any fat except for the natural oiliness of the walnuts. So now this is the time to add the final ingredients, which are garlic, cilantro, half of cilantro I didn't use, mix, and then taste for salt and pepper. And of course, if you want to add more spices, you can at this stage, and cook for another like 5 minutes. You may be surprised that I added garlic as the final step, because we already used some garlic in the walnut sauce, but that's how Georgians do. They add garlic almost at the end of the cooking process, and it gives amazing flavor to the stews and dishes. So let's cook for another 5 minutes, and then we will remove it from the heat. Today, my friends, we made the beef stew khracho, which is excellent with hearty bread or a salad or pali dish, which I made yesterday. Actually, this red pali will go very well with khracho stew. If you like the recipe, please share with your family and friends. Come back for my weekly postings. Please subscribe, turn on your notifications. Let's cook together. Bon appétit. Gemrielet mir.